Good evening, everyone. Wow, I've never seen a room full of more glamorous dressed people. You all are awesome. Well, first and foremost, I want to thank you guys for coming to Hawthorne Manor, TeslaCon 12. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Jordan and I am Eric's son. And it is my greatest pleasure to welcome the family Hawthorne.
Now, that was a funeral.
Ah, yes.
Such intense mourning, such powerful sorrow. It seemed it would go on forever. Such a delight.
It was truly lovely, darling. Everyone was so sad, so downcast, so absolutely engulfed in sorrow. And the corpse. You did a wonderful job with the Duchess, I must say. She looked so... serene.
Yes, it was one of my very best works ever.
No, I like the part where the corpse stayed dead.
Her skin was dry as porcelain, like a sphinx with a riddle. You do that?
No, I didn't do that, actually. I left her, went up for lunch, and when I came back, her face had set like that. Very knowing smile. Like she had some secret, and every mourner looked at her and knew she had a secret of them. It must have been wonderfully disconcerting.
Especially disconcerting for her husband.
The choir was inspirational. They sounded like angels. And Her Majesty the Queen was so pleased. She almost never comes out in public. I don't think anyone's seen her since her husband rescued her from the moon.
Yes, it's true. But this is what we Hawthorns do. We make perfect farewells. We bring together all of the elements. The flowers, the lighting, the music, the hearses, the horses.
Yes, Father. I know what our family does. Darling!
Yes, dear?
We have a letter from Edgar in Egypt.
Oh, how is the boy?
See, he's with our cousin RJ in Egypt. The boy needs to cut loose. I think it will help him before he goes off and starts the family business. I think that's dearest father.
Yes, he wants something, doesn't he? That means he's run through his money.
Dearest father and mother, I have met a girl.
Well, good. Well, that's good. Last time he met a dog.
Wonderful. Oh, I wonder who she is. She is. I wonder where he met her. I wonder when we get to meet her.
Perhaps the letter.
Oh, yes, yes. I met her several weeks ago. Oh, there you are, darling. You're so clever. She is from London. But I want you to know, Father and Mother, she is more than just a girl. She is a woman. A wonderful, delightful woman. This is the woman I intend to marry.
To marry?
Yes.
Well, good for the boy. Is it Lord Cecil's daughter?
Oh, I hope not. She's the one that smells like baked carp. Perhaps it is that delightful Penelope Puddlebottom from Bristol. The one with the eye patch.
Yes, no. Yeah, no. She always used to set her father's hunting dogs on Edgar. He does not like her.
I liked her moxie. I thought she was the type of girl that would keep him on his toes. Let's see what else it says. Mother, the woman I love is called Alice Wonderland. She is the most beautiful, wonderful woman in the whole world. I met her here in Egypt. She is sweet and kind and...
We don't know this, Alice, do we? I trust we're going to meet it someday before the wedding. Let's see. Alice is sweet and kind, and I fear for her life.
Oh.
Well, that's exciting. I have sent her back to England. Please protect her, for she is the love of my life. She should arrive at Hawthorne Manor on the, that would be today.
Oh, well, I'll have an extra place set for tea. I'm sure that we will love her.
Well, let's see. Alice is not like us. She is
Dutch?
No. Different. I know you will make her feel welcomed, but I feel it's only fair to warn you, she's...
Yoo-hoo! She's here!
Everyone, best behavior, please. Do not embarrass the family. Lady.
Miss Wonderland, I presume. Welcome to our home. Edgar has told us so.
Mother!
It is so nice to finally meet you. Eddie has told me so much about you.
Mother? Eddie? Well, this is not what I expected.
Nor I, and I expected very little.
Bummer!
No. I think she's trying to hug me.
I'm sorry, I'm a big hugger. I like to hug. I think everyone needs more hugs, don't you? This world would be so much better off if we all just hugged more.
Hugged more?
I love your home. It's so unique and lovely.
Thank you, dear.
It's not Georgian, Regency, or modern. I just can't place my finger on it. What do you call this decorating style?
Funerary.
That's it! It looks just like my grandfather's funeral.
Oh,
that was a sad day. But it was also a happy day, because it meant his pain was over, and he could cross over into the next life full of peace.
Oh, that's sweet.
After he passed, I planted flowers on his grave, flowers from every color of the rainbow, so that people would know how much light he brought into the world.
Attentive to her grandfather's grave, that is lovely. Do you visit him often?
And does he ever visit you?
And where is he buried? Is he in Highgate?
Oh, Grandfather was an informal man. He insisted we bury him in his overalls and a work shirt because he said that's how God would know him best.
Work shirt? Work clothes? You can't be buried in your work clothes. How will God know you? It's just not proper. I mean, not unless you've maybe gone down with a sinking ship.
Or a mullet immolated in a burning building.
Or buried alive underneath the corner of a great pyramid.
Oh, suits are so stuffy and needlessly formal. I keep telling Eddie he needs to freshen up his wardrobe.
He needs to get his clothes off the floor.
And you must be darling Tilly.
I don't like hugs.
Well, you're a pure delight. And you must be Clayton.
You have an excellent bone structure.
Why, thank you.
Your skull would look amazing in a museum.
Thank you?
Would you consider donating to me once you're deceased?
I'm Aunt Minerva.
And what do you do?
Oh, I'm a hedge witch.
I'm not familiar with hedge witches.
Oh, yes, you are. You've met me.
Oh. How wonderful. What do hedge witches do?
Ooh, mysterious things. And we tell the future.
Is the future interesting?
Oh, yes. For example, next year, Lord Bobbins is going to Egypt.
Oh, my.
How exciting! Shall I go to the garden? I would love to see the bunnies.
I'll show you the garden.
Okay.
But no hugs.
Okay. Thank you, Tilly. That's very kind of you. Mind the ha-ha!
I don't think she's a good match. Her passion is a bit excessive.
Yes, but she does. She does like her dead grandfather. And I don't think we should be too hasty in our judgment, although her fashion sense seems a bit extraordinary.
Oh, she's extra something.
Yes, I'm afraid she's frightfully perky. Perhaps even electrifying, but that is not a quality on which you can build a marriage. I mean, what are the girl's ambitions? How will she help Edgar, our son and heir, to build his own traditions?
I don't know what he wants. All I can tell you, my dear, is the heart wants what the heart wants.
The heart wants to keep beating. That's why decapitated people spray so much blood out of their decapitated stump.
Edgar is currently in love, my dear. You do remember what that was like, don't you?
I do have a memory of you in the moonlight.
Oh, yes.
Wearing that black bombazine dress.
Oh, yes, darling.
And you were bent over.
Yes.
The coffin of Mrs. Hartington.
Yes, darling, yes.
You arranged her gloves with such perfect, loving care. Those were her favorites.
Oh,
and it showed, and everyone knew that she was lying in peace because of you.
We became intoxicated by the formaldehyde.
Formaldehyde and your fine eyes. I weep for the day when they will open no more.
You're such a flirt. Such memories.
Indeed.
Oh, I guess I'm just minced aspect over here.
If we impose Edgar in his choice, it will only make him more determined. Remember, he is a Hawthorne.
Yes, of course, my love.
You should bring her back in.
Yes, Clayton, would you be so kind as to bring Miss Alice Wonderland back into the study here?
Oh, yes, I'd like a lock of her hair.
A lock of her hair? Stiff upper lip, darling.
Oh, I have a potion for stiff upper lips, too.
As we say, yes. Ah.
Courage.
Miss Alice, I have not heard your family name. It doesn't seem to be from around these parts, is it? Are you perhaps Dutch?
Oh, I have no idea. I was born in London. I'm as English as fish and chips.
Well, that's a relief.
Fish and chips was originated in Portugal.
Oh, well then, I'm as English as afternoon tea?
Tea comes from India or China mostly.
Oh, well then, I'm as English as getting drunk at a pub in the middle of the afternoon and fighting someone.
Well, actually, the Romans started that one.
That's no matter, no matter. Tell me, what does your father do, Miss Wonderland?
Complains, mostly. Papa loves to complain.
No. I meant for work. What does he do for work?
Well, complains, mostly. He loves to complain about work the most.
How? Let me try and see. How does he make his money?
Well, he works for his clients, and then they pay him.
Yes, I suppose that is correct. What do his clients have him do?
Well, lots of things, I guess. I suppose that's why he complains so much.
Of course he does. I am speaking English here. I am speaking English to her. You can understand the words coming from my face.
Alice, my dear girl, I think what Lord Hawthorne is trying to say and ask you is, in what field of work is your father employed?
Precisely, yes. In what field?
Oh, many fields. And sometimes lawns, occasionally a forest. Father's work takes him through all sorts of terrain.
Well, I guess why I know she finds Edgar attractive.
No. Let's try this one more time. Suppose I hire your father. What would your father do for me?
Why, his job, of course.
Of course. And his job is?
It's what he does to make money. Oh, I'm late.
For what?
A very important date. It was so nice meeting all of you, and I'm sure we'll have much more time for fun in the very near future.
Fun?
She's a perfectly lovely young woman. She's very pretty. But she lacks a certain gravitas.
Gravitas means seriousness and solemnity.
Yes, dear. It does.
I don't know. Maybe Edgar says something else in his letter.
Oh, letter, perhaps.
Yes, here we are. Alice has a kind heart. and she's a very loving. You should see her with the baby bunnies. If she loves her children even a fraction as much as she loves the baby bunnies, then their children will be the most cared for children in the world.
Oh, Edgar. Children are not rabbits.
Thankfully, or else we would have eaten baby stew for supper last night.
I don't think Edgar understands what it takes to build and maintain a relationship. It's more than just kind hearts and loving feelings.
You have to build a life together. You have to help each other become more than you would have separately. You need goals, you need aspirations to pursue together.
Yes, and moreover, we must discuss her clothing. And we are morticians. We bury the dead and console the living. No one wants a walking rainbow when they're grieving their mother. They want propriety, they want gravitas. They don't want a stranger trying to hug them. They want that darkness with their death. It gives them security. It makes them happy.
Yes. There are other women for Edgar. Women who'll understand what we do and why we do it.
He must
marry a woman with proper gravitas.
He must marry a woman that understands tradition. I mean, we are the Hawthorns. This is what we do. Alice is so...
Sunny.
Dreadfully sunny.
Colorful.
Painfully colorful.
Yes. Edgar is currently experiencing what we call love blindness. It happens sometimes with young people.
No good. No good will come of this union. I feel it's best we just have him break it off with her and let him know that we have a decorum to maintain, and Alice just is not part of that decorum.
But, darling, you must remember that Edgar has a propensity toward melodrama.
Yes.
He may forsake the entire family and all its tradition if we disparage his beloved.
No, no. Edgar would never give up the family tradition.
Sure.
I'm very sure. Because he is my son Adair. He will carry on. Well, who else will if not Edgar?
Well, I guess I'm ice cold haggis.